The gospel
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately the man regained his sight and followed Jesus on the way. The Gospel of the
Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today, World Mission Sunday, is an opportunity for us to reflect on our part in the missionary role of the Church. The Church has been involved in missionary work right from the very beginning, because the need to bring the spiritual gift of the Gospel to people is an essential part of the Lord's command. When we talk about mission and missionary activities, it reminds me how Jesus called me to do his mission. From my childhood onwards, I was very much interested in becoming a priest. My family atmosphere really helped me to have such a goal in my mind. When I look back to my childhood, I think of many examples: partaking in daily family prayer, attending the Holy Mass on every holy day as an altar server, and partaking in children's retreat every year. More than these, I was blessed by having many interactions with priests, nuns, and even a bishop who are from my family. When I finished my 10th grade at the age of 15, I joined the seminary in North India as a missionary for the Diocese of Bijnor. During my priestly formation and in the last 8 years of my priestly life, I have experienced immensely God's love, caring and protecting hand as He has chosen me to be part of His mission. This was especially true in the second year of my priesthood when I was secretary to my bishop. It happened on December 25th in 2013 when my bishop and I were traveling back from a church after Christmas celebration. The church was 40 kilometers away from the bishop's house in the hills. I was driving the jeep and my bishop was sitting beside me. Since we had another Christmas program in the cathedral church, we were rushing back. The road was narrow. One side of the road was a mountain and the other side was a huge quarry. On our way, a motorcycle came around a sharp bend. And while I was trying to stop to avoid the motorcycle, my jeep slipped into the quarry since the road was narrow. The jeep started to roll down. The vehicle went almost 150 feet down in the quarry, and when it stopped, the vehicle was upside down. Somehow, I managed to get out of the vehicle. When I saw the vehicle, it was completely damaged and good for nothing. Even I couldn't believe that there was no single scratch on my body, and I was perfectly fine. Thanks be to God, My bishop also had a miraculous escape with minor injuries in his leg. My brothers and sisters, the moment accident happened, I was praying to Mama Mary the rosary. And when vehicle started to roll down, my bishop was shouting to Jesus, the name of Jesus. Then and there, I experienced the protecting hands of Mother Mary and Jesus. Another part of my mission has been role before coming to Canada. I acknowledge myself blessed to have had an opportunity to render my service to Ashadi, a center for people who are differently abled. There, after my 4 years of service there, I have sent you for the ministry here in Canada to find some benefactors and some projects to support my mission. The center promotes integrated education and rehabilitation. There we have 230 special kids with various deformities, the hearing impaired, the visually impaired, the physically challenged, the mentally challenged, and the paralyzed. The vision of the center is to create a society with integration and equality. The missionaries who are at the service take care of the poor with whatever limited means they have, because its center is situated in very remote village. The missionary spirit and the power of prayer helped me to carry out the work entrusted to me there. During those 4 years, I was taking care of the agricultural land and dairy farm. Early in the morning, after mass, I used to go to the field with the laborers for work or to the dairy farm to take care of the cows. After working for the whole day or maybe till late night, I never went to sleep if I didn't go to the church or to the grotto of Mother Mary and say 4 rosaries a day. My dear friends, this is the secret of my priestly life and the zeal for the mission of the Lord. This is the prime aspect Jesus himself had during his missionary journey in this world. We see him in the Bible during his public life, spending the whole day preaching the good news and healing the sick. At the end of the day, he used to spend time in prayer with his Father. We see in St. Mark's Gospel chapter 1. That helped him to fulfill his Father's will on this earth. My dear friends, we can also participate in the missionary actions of the church through our prayers. St. Teresa of Lisieux is a great example of this. Even though she never left her convent in France, she was a spiritual sister for 2 missionary priests, supporting them through her letters and prayers. And she had a great missionary zeal for all people to know Christ. As a result, she is one of the patroness of all missions, together with St. Francis Xavier. Today's celebration of Mission Sunday reminds us all that we have an important role in the spreading of the gospel. Let me tell you a small story so that we can have a deeper understanding of our role and mission. An old man was going around planting small fruit trees. Someone asked him, when this tree would bear fruit? He You reply, "Oh, probably many years after I am gone from this earth." The questioner asked, "So then why plant trees when you won't be around to enjoy the fruits?" His reply was this: "When I came into this world, I didn't find this world without any fruit trees. I enjoy the fruits. Now I plant these fruit trees for those who will come after me, just as those who have done before me." The old man's words are profound. "I plant these fruit trees for those who will come after me, just as those who have done before me." When we reflect upon the words of old man, we will also come to a deeper understanding of our faith and mission. We will come to see that the faith we have had been built upon and handed down to us by the earlier generation of believers. What we have received, my dear brothers and sisters, we too must build up and hand over to the next generation. That is not just the work of missionaries, priests, religious, and selected few parishioners. Let us pray that God may help each of us to remember that we are all called to be missionaries in one way or another, in home or abroad. Let us join our prayers to those of St. Teresa, patroness of missions, interceding for the missionaries throughout the world, that God will give them courage, strength, patience, and ever greater love. Through our collaboration with the Holy Spirit, may all nations come to know, love, and serve the one true God, and to love each other as sisters and brothers in Christ. Amen.